Are you using Zoom? Are you on a paid plan on Zoom? And are you using the cloud recording function? Then you know that the storage is limited and you want to have a workaround to upload or download your recordings to another place. And then you can use them there, distribute them and keep them with unlimited or at least a lot cheaper storage. Then keep watching this video. I will show you how to do that. Hey, my name is Manuel and I'm the founder of TechFlow.ai and we love automation. In this video, I will show you exactly how you can make use of other cloud storages to not fill up your Zoom cloud storage if you are recording your Zoom meetings to the cloud. So we're using a tool called Integromat and you can get a 1 month free trial if you follow my link below of a paid plan and you can test it out on yourself. It's basically a tool where you can connect anything with anything and it's super powerful. I love working with it and I've been working with it for over 5 years now and you can do almost anything with it. It's like visual coding. So I highly recommend check it out. Just click the link below in the video in the description to get a free trial on it. All right, so what we are going to do is we check all the new cloud recordings. Then we download the URL, then we download the recording and we upload it to our own cloud storage. For example, Google Drive in my case, but you can also use Dropbox or any other server or whatever you wanna use for the storage. And then we also wanna make sure that the cloud recording is deleted from Zoom so it doesn't count towards our quota, our limit that we have on Zoom right now. So in Integromat, this is how it will look like. We have our watch recordings module, then we check where we have a filter. If the download URL exists, then we want to download the cloud recording. Then we can even set a filter to check if the recording is above a certain amount of size. I have done that because oftentimes I have my recording starting automatically, but then I decide at the very beginning of the call, okay, I actually don't want to record this call. So I stop it right away. And then it's always below 5 megabytes. But if it's an actual call, it's always above 5 megabytes. So that's why I have added this filter in here to check if it's greater than 5 megabytes. And only then I want to upload it to my Google Drive. And if it's below 5 megabytes, I want to just ignore it and just delete the cloud recording because then I have no use for it. Then I have a filter here with a router here with filter and various paths after that, where I check if the title is regular meeting 1, regular meeting 2, or if it's another recording, then I upload it to certain folders in my Google Drive. And for example, this could be a weekly team meeting where you want to give all of your team members access to. So you just check the title of that meeting on Zoom and then you upload it into the team folder and everyone has access right away to it and you don't have to touch it at all. Then this module is very important because this actually deletes the cloud recording and then it doesn't count towards your storage on Zoom. Now let's get into a little bit more details on how to set that up. First thing is that we have to check if the download URL exists. And this is a little bit tricky because it's not too obvious. So you have to dig down a little bit. It's under payload, then you have to go to recording and then search for recording files. Then choose the first one and use download URL. So this one. This is the one that you will need to check if the download URL exists. And if it exists, then we want to download it. So you use it here inside the download URL. Then for download token, you have to search for the download token. This is actually in the main part of this or main level of this watch recordings module. So you add the download token. Then for file name, what I like to do is I want to always add the current date. So I put the now variable here and format it with year, month and date. So day, sorry. And then it's always alphabetical if I sort it. And then the recording topic, you can find it under payload, then recording again, and then under topic. This is the actual title of your meeting. So this is what I use as the file name, so I know like which recording it is. Then for this one, this is basically how I'm doing it. So I check the length of the recording, this output, so that is the data. and then check if it's greater than 5 million. And if it is greater than 5 million, then that means it's above 5 megabytes, and only then I want to have it continue. And then for the filters here, I just check the recording topic. So again, it's under recording and then topic, and check if it contains case insensitive, and then like my meeting name that I have regularly set up every week. And then I just upload it to a certain folder on Google Drive by using, I use the map feature here. And it's important to put a .mp4 behind the file name, otherwise it won't work properly and Google won't be able to format it properly. So always make sure to have the .mp4 here, otherwise it doesn't work. Then for the data, we use the recording from our Download a Cloud Recording module. So this is the full setup. Then I have another regular meeting, and for other recordings, I just check the box, the fallback route, which means if it can't find any of these ones or can't match any of these filters, it will just go that way. Then there's another handy module that you can use, which allows you to get a share link. So you can just use this module. You insert the file ID of the previous one, and you can set the type to anyone, or you can set it to a user, and then you can type a specific email address of the user that you want to give access to this file to. So of course, you have to make sure that you know like which email you want to send that to. This would come afterwards. And you have to have some sort of a database, or have them as invitees on your Zoom meeting as actual guests, so you can get the emails out. And last but not least, it will go down here and then delete the cloud recording that we got here, because we have processed it. We don't need it anymore, and that way we keep our storage low on Zoom. And there's currently a little issue here with the meeting ID and the mapping, which is not correctly shown currently in the interface, but this will probably be updated soon. So at the time you're watching this, it might be not recording ID, but actual meeting ID. Because right now, if you go into it, go into recording, and then the recording ID is actually the meeting ID. So this should be the meeting ID, and then it's mapping here correctly. And the recording ID field, this is actually the recording file ID. So if I go into payload, recording, recording files, and then the recording file ID. So this one is actually what you need here in order to delete it. If you have any questions about that, let me know in the comments, and make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel to get more helpful tips on Zoom and TiggMod and automation in general. And if you want to learn how this all works, like if you want to get an A to Z course, advanced course on IntegraMod, and really learn everything step by step, then check out the link in the description below. I've got a full advanced course which makes you an expert on IntegraMod and automation, and you will be able to build all of this in no matter of time and really save a lot of time on doing this manually. I was doing it before manually, like downloading the recording, uploading it to a certain Google Drive folder, sharing it and giving it to whoever needed access to it. And that was really time consuming. So, yep, check this out. And if you have any questions, let me know. Thanks.